Hello, everybody. My name is Father Pete McCormick. I'm joined by my co-host, Lynnette Wukie, and welcome to One Big Question. Today, we are joined by Melissa Stevens. Melissa Stevens is the Assistant Director for the Genomic and Bioinformatics Core Facility. We are so lucky to have her with us. And so, Lynnette, what do you say?
I say we go and have Melissa give us a tour. Let's go. So here we are in the lab, but before that, I want you to tell us what you do in your regular day-to-day job.
So I'm the Assistant Director for the Genomics and Bioinformatics Core Facility here on campus.
Okay, so where are we now, and what do you do here?
We are in McCourtney Hall, and we are in the saliva surveillance testing lab, and I oversee the daily operation of the lab.
So Melissa, if you're open to it, now that we have these sweet coats, would you go and walk us through a little bit in terms of how the process works?
I'd love to.
Awesome, thank you.
Perfect, let's see it.
Once the samples are delivered to the lab, they go into this room for the preprocessing. So the first step is a heat inactivation. The samples will go into a hot water bath at 95 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes. We can process about 400 samples at any given time. The next step is barcode scanning, which also occurs in this room. So once the saliva arrives in the lab, it's destined for two kind of parallel workflows. The first is the manual transfer, where each sample is transferred manually by one of the technicians throughout the process. The other is the automated workflow.
So once the barcodes are scanned, they come into the main part of the lab where we transfer the saliva from the individual 50 mil conical tubes into a 96 well plate that's been preloaded with buffer in an equal volume. The next stage would be to take that plate of diluted saliva and move it into another 96 well plate where the PCR Mastermix chemistry is added.
In the next step, our technicians transfer the diluted saliva to another 96 well PCR plate where they add the chemistry that makes the reaction work. So this includes the enzyme, the primers, and an internal control to every sample. The next stage, that plate will then move to one of four Quant Studio qPCR machines to run the program. After the PCR Mastermix has been added, the plate moves into one of our four Quant Studio machines. These are qPCR machines, and they're used to detect the presence of COVID genes. So as you can see on this screen, this is some of the results that come off of the qPCR run for that particular plate. There are 94 samples on this plate, and these are individual student samples. There's a positive control and a negative control that are added to each plate. And here you can see the status of each of the samples. Negatives, some positives on here, and then this is an invalid sample. The other is the automated workflow. And this is on a Beckman Biomech Span 8 system. The reason that the saliva may go for an automated workflow versus the manual workflow is that there are a lot of different types of saliva, and some saliva is better handled manually than in an automated fashion, as well as just for technician fatigue in order to process a lot of samples quickly. During this process, the saliva is transferred from the tubes into the plates, but this also adds the Mastermix reagents for the PCR. The plate that comes off is ready to go right into one of our Quant Studio qPCR machines.
Melissa, thanks so much for your time today. One last question though for you. Once it finishes up here in the lab, where does this information go?
So once we've reviewed the data that comes off the machine, we send that forward to the next team, who then digests it further and gets it into your inbox.
That's awesome. Well, Melissa, thank you so much. And I also want to thank everybody that works in this lab and every lab on campus to continue to keep our community safe and make sure that we get to stay here at Notre Dame. Make sure you follow us on Instagram and Twitter. Keep submitting those questions. Have a great week. And Melissa, I just want to let you know, I'm keeping the code.